Yes, Miss Norma?
Yes.
Yes, how far are you from the post office?
About 10 to 15 minutes.
Okay, I want you to get there safely, and I don't want any interference with anyone calling you and telling you not to do this.
Okay.
You need to send this over at Express, and you're going to get a receipt, and I'll ask you for the code on the receipt. So you need to get there quickly, okay?
Okay.
All right. In God we trust. You know I love you, so I'm trying to get this over with for you.
Oh, thank you. Honey, I had no idea.
Lit wings reflect the stars that guide me towards salvation.
You can go out on a nice date after this.
Oh, that would be wonderful.
I know, so just have to take care of quickly. Stay on the line and do not answer your phone.
Okay.
Can I trust you, Doctor? Your phone when it rang?
What about Mr. Miller? Did I hang up on him?
No, no, no. Mr. Miller on the line.
Okay, I'll hang up on him.
Either. All right, because I'm looking to have a dinner date with you, sweetheart.
Oh, that's wonderful. Where would you like to go on the date?
You want to go on the beach?
What's that?
Go on the beach?
Oh, I love the beach. What do you like to do on the beach?
Well, there, we can go on a date. Not sure if we can let
them. Oh, I'm getting another call.
Hello, Moto.
Hello? Hello? Hello?
I seek to cure what's deep inside, frightened of this thing that I've become. It's gonna take a lot to get me away from you. There's nothing that 100 men or more could ever do. I bless
the Norma, you need to stop answering that phone, Miss Norma.
Oh, so I should hang up on Mr. Miller? That's who is calling.
Not Miller. Okay?
Okay.
You need to get to the post office quickly, and you need to get this done, because I don't want any interference. Understand why I told you I love you when I want to take you out on a date and you're not listening.
Oh, well, that sounds nice, honey.
Calls, okay? Sweetheart.
Okay.
How much do you have a turd phone with you?
No, I don't have a turd phone.
Which phone keeps on ringing? The one that I'm on or the one that Mr. Miller is on?
For some reason, honey, both phones just keep ringing and ringing.
So who gave you these phones?
Well, one is mine, and then the other one is from my son. Yes.
Right, because I want you for your best interest. I don't want you to answer them when they ring.
Okay.
Until you get this done. If you get this done, then whatever we can talk about that. Because I'm going to set up a nice dinner date for you.
That sounds lovely.
In the afternoon. Okay?
Okay.
Okay. Answer those phones once they ring. So you need to get this taken care of.
Okay.
Right, I'm going to make reservation for the two of us at 6 o'clock, so I need to get yourself sorted out. Okay?
Okay.
And make sure you keep on time. Okay?
Okay.
Yeah, I need him on the line. Alright, so you need to quickly get to your destination and have this mailed off, okay?
Okay.
Remember, you're going to send it. And listen. What you're going to do for me, sweetheart, because you
hold on 1 second, honey. My phone's ringing. Hold on.
Hello? Hello?
Yes, hi.
Is this Norma?
Yes, this is Norma.
Oh, hi, Norma. This is Steve Jobs. We spoke yesterday.
Oh, hi, Steve.
Yes, I was wondering,
Do you have the ability to go back to your account again and wire transfer me some more money?
Oh, honey, I transferred you $23,000 yesterday. What do you need the money for?
Well, honey, it's actually that we just need to take some transfer taxes, and we can go ahead and get you that delivery later today.
Oh, that sounds lovely. How much do you need me to transfer?
Well, if you could do a wire transfer for $45,000, I can get you an airplane. You have won an airplane of your choice.
Oh my goodness, I've never won an airplane before.
Yes, it's an airplane, it's a private jet. Norma, where are you?
Oh, I was driving over to the post office. Mr. Anderson, are you there?
Yes, I'm on the line. I'm on the line also.
Do you work with Steve?
You're speaking with...
Do you work with Steve Jobs?
I hear you're speaking with an agent. There is no problem, but you need to take care of this before you can have that for the agent. So there's no problem,
no,
okay?
I'm sorry, sir. She's going to need to take care of this one immediately. This is very important. This is for a private jet.
Yes, but listen to what... Very important. She's going to have this done, so she's going to get home in the next 10 minutes. So you can take care of your transaction.
Yeah, no.
There won't be any problem. Okay.
What, can I just have you head to the bank first, please, Norma? This is very urgent. I need to get to the private jet immediately. It's actually fueled up.
Miss Norma?
Hello?
Yes, hello?
Yeah, right. We want you to head to the post office, and after you go to the post office, you go to the bank. You already have the mail for the post office.
No, I'm afraid I'm going to need you to go to the bank, then the post office, please, Norma.
No.
No,
man, what is Norma? Listen to me. Why you can't give her a second to head over to the post office and then you have her head to the bank?
Well, because the bank is much more important than the post office. I need a word.
No,
yes.
Both of them is important.
Yeah, no, but it's more important because this is for the private jet.
Yes,
Norma.
Yes.
Who is this guy you're talking to? Because he's playing really greedy.
Who is this guy? This is Steve Jobs.
Okay, so why can't you? We need you to take care of this at the post office, and then you can do whatever you're doing. Why is he playing so greedy? He's being dishonest now.
Why are you being greedy, bro? We need to get to the bank first.
No. So what you want to do? Stop her from going to the post office?
Where am I supposed to go, honey? I'm getting very confused.
The post office.
You're going to need to go to the bank.
And then you're going. Then after
I
the post
to go
office.
To the bank?
Then after the post office,
I'm going to need you to go to the bank right away, please. And then you
go straight over to the post office. We're coming with your package today. We're coming with $20 million for you today. We're on our way. Go to the post office.
Ma'am, the private jet is actually flying into your airport right now. We need to
get
there for
that
private jet.
Because this guy's playing really greedy. Could you hang the phone up on this guy right now? You're playing greedy, bro. You get your chance, and now we're trying to make this happen. You're trying to turn her back. This is not right.
I'm going to need you to get to the private jet immediately.
Oh, I'm sorry. Who should I hang up on?
The only one you need to
hang
talk
up on the guy. Hang up on the guy that's telling you about the private jet. He's too greedy.
Okay, I hung up on him.
Yes. Go straight to the post office now.
We're going to need you to go to the bank.
Don't answer back his phone. Don't take back his call.
We're going to have to go to the bank. Okay, I'm not going to pick.
Okay, so I shouldn't talk to Mr. Anderson?
Go to the post office. Talk to Mr. Anderson.
I'm going to need you to go right to the bank, please. It's immediate. I need you there now, please.
Listen to me, Miss Norma. Go straight to the post office.
Hello?
Yes, go straight to the post office. That guy, that's the reason, sweetheart, I told you not to talk to these guys.
I need, Mr. Steve Jobs says I have to go to the bank and then get to go to the post office so I can get my private jet.
Oh, sweetheart, I have everything here for you. I don't want you to turn back. You're already going to the post office. So go to the post office now, and then you can get to the bank.
Do not turn around. This gentleman,
stay on the line and do not talk to that person. Mr. Miller?
This gentleman that's speaking now, he doesn't know what he's talking about. I need you to go to the bank right away, please.
Go straight to the post office.
These guys are the delivery drivers. They're not really sure what's going on. They're just going to do the delivery.
That you're getting just confused. You're playing really greedy now.
I'm the manager. I'm Steve Jobs, and I'm going to need you to go to the bank.
Listen, Miss Norma.
Yes.
Hang up the other phone. Hang the other phone up.
Well, go ahead and hang up on the delivery drivers. I can take care of it from
right
there.
Now, and then you'll see this is better for you because this person is quite greedy.
I don't know why he's going to get
on
a private
hang
jet.
The phone up, miss.
Okay.
And then you'll see he's playing.
Yes, ma'am. The other guys, they're just delivery drivers. They don't know what they're talking about.
Hello?
Yes, but my phone's ringing again.
You need to head to the bank, to the post office.
So, go to the bank. It's super important. And then after you finish at the bank, you can go to the post office.
Listen, sir. You're making this really hard for her. You don't want to listen. You don't want to share.
Yeah, no, I don't.
You want everything to go. Well, listen, what's your name? Let me speak to you now. What's your name?
My name's Steve. Steve Jobs.
All right, listen to me, Mr. Steve. We're not trying to stop anything for you, right? She's probably 10 minutes away from the post office right now, right? And we already have her doing a business for us. So let her deal with this, and then we'll let you do what you're doing. We're not trying to stop your thing. So don't try to stop our thing.
Well, I mean,
right? We know.
This is my client, Norma, and yesterday she sent me $23,000, and it wasn't quite enough to cover the private jet, and I want to make sure she gets the private jet immediately.
I know that she sent you $23,000, right? And
yes.
I know that you are going to get your share.
Yes.
We're
yes.
not trying to blot you
so
from your money.
Sure,
we're not
I just
want to
make sure that
for
I,
you.
I get done first, and then you guys can pick over the scraps.
What did you say?
I just want to get done first, and you guys can pick over the scraps.
Oh, how could you get done first when we have her doing something? Where are you from?
What do you mean, where am I from?
You're really dishonest now. She's going to do what you want her to do. I know that because she's been sending you money, and we never have a problem with that.
I've been getting the money.
Bro, come on.
I've been getting the money, man. So just chill out. She'll call you later.
No, you need to chill out.
Who do I need to send the money to?
Listen, go to the post office road.
Norma,
how far are you from the post office?
Here's what I want you to do, Norma. Can you just write a check for $50 for the two guys on the phone, and then that will take care of them. They'll be all settled, and then you can go
hey,
back and do
the
bank transfer.
Hey, listen, shut up and get off the phone.
Yes, you can just write them a check for $50.
So I just need to write a check for $50?
Miss Norma, you're not listening to me. This is more Anderson. Listen, you need to hang the phone up on that guy right now because I don't know what he's talking about. He's playing really greedy.
Steve helped me a lot yesterday. He helped me.
Hang up the next phone, Miss Norma.
Yes,
get that guy off the line.
Yeah, no,
you already sent him $23,000. What the hell is he talking about?
Yeah, no, it's cool, man. Just go ahead and Norma, go ahead and send him $50 each, and that should take care. That should make them whole.
Shut up and stop talking. Hey, nigger, stop.
Just send them $50. It's fine. They'll be happy with that. They're gonna go down to the salt spring later with $50 in their pocket. They'll be happy.
All right, listen, Miss Norma, hang the phone up.
I'm confused. What's the gentleman talking about? You just need $50?
No. You need to go to the post office with the money that you have. Drive to
the
post office with the money that you have and send it off, and then you go do whatever Steve wants you to do.
Norma, do you have cash?
Steve, hang the phone up on Steve because Steve is being greedy. Send Steve $23,000, and then he wants you to send him $40,000 more.
But
you need to hang the phone up on Steve.
I'm confused, though.
Right now.
I'm confused.
Where are you,
Norma? Norma, do you have cash for these guys? Norma, do you have cash for these guys?
Yeah, she has cash for us.
Yes, I have $9,000. I was going to send it to Mr. Anderson.
That's fine. Here's what you can do. You can open up that package and go ahead and take
$50. No, do not open the package, Miss Norma.
Why
can't you listen to us?
Take $50.
Hang the phone up on Mr. Steve.
Take $50
Mr. Steve, why are you behaving like that?
I don't know what to do. What should I do?
Yeah, it's fine.
Hang the phone up, Mr. Steve.
Take $50 out. Take $50 out and give it to each one of these guys on the phone, and they'll be fine.
in the Bronx
go straight to the post office with the package and have it sent off, and then you go to the bank for Steve.
Norma, go ahead and hang up on these guys. They're the delivery drivers. They'll meet you at the house later.
Oh, not Ms.
Norma. No, we are the CEO.
Who do I hang up on?
Hang up on the other guy that's telling you about the private jet.
I always wanted a private jet. Oh, but he's going to give me a private jet.
No, we have a wonderful airplane, Norman. It's coming to your local airport right now. We have a dinner date at six.
These guys on the phone were delivery drivers, but I think they're about to be fired.
Mr. Steve, you're an asshole.
Yes,
hang the phone up on Mr. Steve, Norma.
I think we're going to work. I work for the Publishers Clearinghouse, man, and I think
we're not working for any publishing clearinghouse, asshole.
I think we're going to fire. You already get
$23,000, and now you want $43 more.
We're going to have to fire these two delivery drivers. They're being very unprofessional.
That phone.
They are
hang
very
the phone
unprofessional.
Up on
and
Steve,
Norma,
I told you yesterday
that we would go out for dinner afterwards, Norma. So just go hang up on these two unprofessional delivery drivers.
No.
So I don't need to talk to the delivery drivers anymore.
You have to talk to the delivery driver. We're the one that's going to get your prize to you right now, in one hour's time.
But Steve
Ms.
Jobs,
Norma,
he,
if you're hearing me, this is Mark Anderson.
I'm the manager. I'm Steve Jobs. I'm the manager here. Yes, I'm Steve Jobs. I'm the manager. You can go ahead and hang up on Mark Anderson. He's just an assistant delivery driver. He's an assistant delivery driver. He's not very good.
Norma, listen to me. It's Mark Anderson. You're getting confused.
Yes, I'm so confused.
I want you to hang
right
the phone up on Steve right now.
You want me to hang
Steve
up on Mr. Miller?
No, on Steve.
Okay,
Steve.
I hung it up on Mr. Miller.
Okay, yeah, that's good. Now just hang it up on the other one, and then we'll be good. So you can go ahead and head over to the bank.
Do not do that, ma'am.
You can just go ahead and head over to the bank.
Hang the phone up on Mr. Steve. Hang the phone up on Mr. Steve, okay?
Oh no, I'm getting another call.
Answer that call. Ma'am, answer your phone. Answer that call. The secretary is calling.
Hello?
You need to hang up on Mrs.
Hello?
Hello?
Yes.
Hello?
Yes.
Yes, hello. Who's this?
I'm working with Mr. Anderson.
Okay, hold on one second. Norma, I'm going to have my secretary call you.
Is Mr. Anderson on the phone?
Yes, Mr. Anderson is still here. Miss Norma, you need to go to the post office.
Yeah, these two bumbaclot.
Where are you right now, Miss Norma?
These two bumbaclot delivery drivers, they're still on the phone. They're just assistants. You don't have to worry about them. Just listen to Steve Jobs.
So Steve Jobs, why are you behaving like that, man?
I don't know. Well, I'm not behaving anyway. I don't know who Steve Jobs is. He helped me yesterday.
Well, what I'm saying to you, Miss Norma, we already spoke about this. You're getting confused, so you need to get Steve off the phone.
Well, no, Steve helped
That's
me
what
yesterday.
I
you. He's going to get me a private jet.
Yeah, Miss Norma, you know what you need. Miss Norma, you know what you need to do.
Yes,
you need to continue drive to the post office. Continue drive and go to the post office. Don't stop on the road. Go to the post office, and when you're in the parking lot, we will talk there. Go straight to the post office parking lot.
Don't do that.
Continue drive.
No, don't do that. I need to go to the bank.
We're coming to meet you right now, Miss Norma, so you need to get
Steve off the phone.
We're going
to meet you at the bank with your private jet. We're going to land the plane at the private jet.
Go straight to the post office.
No, I need you to go to the bank, please.
Go straight to the post office, Miss Norma.
I don't know where to go.
Listen, we already have a jet here for you and everything. We're going to meet you in person today.
I don't know where to go. Where do I go?
I'm going to need you to go to the bank, please. Just go to the bank. No, we're going
to
go to the bank.
Straight to the post office.
No, we got to go to the bank.
Hang up on Mr. Steve. I keep telling you that. Why can't you listen? Get him off the line.
Well, Mr. Steve, he's got my private jet, honey. He's going to deliver it
to
me.
Ma'am, you're not listening. You're causing all of this. Hang the phone up on Mr. Steve now.
And that's it, so we can get this on the go for you. Hang up on the phone on Batty Boy Mr. Anderson. He's got things to do down in the Salt Spring.
You shut the fuck up.
What? What did you say?
Hello?
That wasn't... Oh, my gosh. I can't even take that kind of language.
That's what Mr. Steve... Steve said. Mr. Steve used the F word. Hang the phone up on
goodness,
Mr. Steve.
Oh, my goodness. I've never heard such things. Why would you say that?
That's Mr.
Wasn't,
Steve.
That wasn't me. That was the other guy.
Mr. Steve, Mr. Steve is saying that. All those F words.
Oh my God! What kind of delivery driver would say that? You're gonna be fired for sure. Oh my
God! No, you said that, Mr. Steve. Hang the phone up on Mr. Steve.
Mr. Steve is gonna be sucking penis in Trenchtown. That's what he's gonna be doing.
Hang the phone up.
I don't know why are you guys talking like this.
You need to drive to the post office. That's what you need to do. Don't listen to the conversation. Continue to drive to the post office.
But I don't know. Mr. Steve said to go to the bank.
After you go to the post office, you will go to the bank. Why, Mr. Steve, cannot understand? We are not messing with the bank with Mr. Steve. You already had a mail for us. Go to the post office and drop it off, and then we get off the phone, and you have a good talk with Mr. Steve. That's so simple.
But then Mr. Anderson said he's going to meet me for a date later.
Tell her to get this guy off the line, Miller.
That's so simple for us. That's so simple. We're just going to get out of Mr. Steve way as soon as you get to the post office.
Mrs. Norma, I need to be honest with you right now. Can I be honest with you for a second?
Yes, you can be honest.
These two gentlemen were fired from the company. They were having sex in the delivery truck, and they were fired from the company. They were having sex with each other.
Listen to me, Miss Marmer. Listen to me. Nothing like that. Go straight to the post office.
So they don't work for the company anymore?
Steve is the one that doesn't work for the company.
No, they don't work for the company. They were caught for having sex in the delivery truck.
Steve is the one that do not work for the company.
So they were fired?
No.
Nothing like that, Miss Marmer.
I don't know what to do.
Oh,
well.
Hello?
Yes. No. Yes.
I don't.
What I want you to listen, you
listen,
need to go to the post
office. Here's what I need you to do. I need you to hang up.
I
need you to hang up on these two delivery drivers. They're probably going to meet for lunch and then, you know, eat each other's hot dogs or something. So you can go and hang up on these two guys.
No, I
don't know what to do, Mr. Jobs. I already transferred you the money.
Exactly. You need to send the money. Oh, you need to go to the post office and have this taken care of, right? And then,
Mr. Anderson, I already sent you $10,000 on Friday. Remember?
You sent him $10,000 on Friday?
I know, but listen to what I'm saying. You already sent...
Oh, it sounds like Mr. Anderson's being a little greedy too then, huh? You're being a little greedy too then, bro.
Listen.
You got $10,000 already, huh? That's my money.
Listen. What's your money? Mr. Norma?
Yeah, hello?
Where are you?
I'm pulled over at the McDonald's. I'm at the Mickey D's.
All right, continue and go to the post office.
Yeah, don't listen to this guy. Go ahead and go to the bank. Go to the bank and let me know when you're at the bank, honey. You don't have to listen to these guys. These guys
that guy's telling you all these crap.
I don't know who to believe here. Well, I don't know what to do.
All right, see, they're talking Spanish or something. You can go ahead and hang up on them.
Yeah,